With October being such a slow news month, I thought, why not dip into the viewer questions bag? So we have a question from Keith. He says, am I slurring my words? I should have had more coffee this morning. Christopher, you put a lot of miles on your 2013 Model S, and just about everything was fixed at some point. Quite true. Did you ever have an MCU failure? There seems to be a lot of confusion about whether time on, or age, or temperature, or something else determines the failure rate of your MCU memory. Curious to hear your experiences. Keith. Well, Keith, and everybody else out there, if you're, instead of writing one email at a time, respond to everybody at the same time. So, here we go. Number one, yes, just about everything on my old car was repaired at some point. It was kind of the running joke that the only thing that didn't outright fail were my seats and my MCU on my old car. That being said, my MCU actually was repaired once-ish. Basically, what happened on mine was, and this was on my old 2013, didn't matter where I touched, it happened just one day driving. Didn't matter where I touched, it wouldn't register where I touched, it would have it all over. Now, given that these are capacitive touch screens, ESD, electric static discharge, you know, static anywhere, poor grounding can cause that. And very much so, that's what fixed it, was Tesla put on a new grounding strap on my MCU, and that took care of the problem. In terms of, in general, what's causing the MCU failures, what my observations have been so far is it's happening in warmer climates. And as we all know, electronics really don't like high temperatures. That being said, the temperature inside a car can get very, very hot. Now, what are some things that Tesla's done to mitigate these temperatures? And what are some things that you can do to help mitigate the temperatures? Well, number one, and this has been on the cars for a very long time, even before they announced cabin overheat protection. If the cabin of the car gets too hot, it will actually turn on the vent and draw in outside air in to help push out the hotter air that's inside the car. This is probably one of the best defenses against it that they have, that's just completely automatic. Next, the MCU actually does have cooling fans on it. If you've ever entered a really hot Model S or X and you heard just a little coming from somewhere under your dash all on its own, and I'm not talking about the sound from the climate control system, that is the, actually, it's more like a kind of noise, real high pitch, because it's just, they're small fans, so they got to go at high RPM. That's the cooling fan trying to circulate some fresh air in through the center console to cool it down. Now, another thing that you can do if you're in a very hot climate, if it's in the cards for you, it's not for everybody, is cabin overheat protection mode. The problem with cabin overheat protection, and that uses the air conditioner of the car to actually cool the car down to a safer temperature, is it draws a lot of power from your main pack. So you could be out, a car could be parked out in the sun all day while you're working, and you come back and you lost 30% of your charge because it's all been blown through your air conditioner and you might not have enough to get home. That's why I don't use cabin overheat protection in the summer here. Although it might be for you, if especially if you can plug in at work, then it's just going to draw shore power for that. But when it comes down to it, the best thing you can do to assist in keeping the not just the center console cool, but your entire car cooler, and also reduces fade, UV damage to any of your interior of your vehicle, the leather, the vinyl, is to get a window sunscreen. They're cheap. If you're a cheap person like me, you can even go to the Dollar Tree and get one. Walmart's got very nice collapsible ones that You just twist and they go down flat. And I just shove it between the seat and the armrest here. And that will reflect out a lot of that sunlight coming in that big windshield that we have on the Model S. And I guess the Model X too, even bigger on the Model X. And trust me, if you got leather seats, especially black leather seats, you will thank me. I have leather or black vinyl seats, which aren't quite as bad as leather, but they sure get hot. Another thing that you can do to help mitigate the heat inside the car is get window tint. Of course, follow your state's laws. And if you don't follow your state's laws, maybe consider getting a doctor's prescription. Some states have little loopholes where if you get an eye doctor's prescription for window tint due to a light sensitivity, you will be able to go down to a darker level. I don't quite have that. My eye doctor won't give it to me, even though I do have a light sensitivity. That all aside, I have 15% on my front windows, 10% on my back windows, and 6% on my trunk window. And holy crap, I went through last summer without tint. I got it towards the end of the summer as I got an excellent deal on tint. I had it, it's about $120 to do everything but my windshield. Not quite as good as the guys that charged over $500, but it's pretty damn good, I'd say. And this year was a hotter, drier summer, and just getting in and out of my car, considerably cooler inside. I am considering getting a very mild tint on my windshield, and even a very mild tint can block a lot of UV and a lot of infrared radiation. It's the infrared radiation that's really warming your car up. So even if I get something like a 90% tint on the front windshield or a 85, it's really not going to affect visibility out the windshield at all. But it is going to significantly drop the temperatures. So I am considering and weighing my options of doing that. It's probably going to cost about $80 to get my front windshield done by the same guys that did the rest of the car. So that's what you can do. Cold really isn't going to cause a failure of your MCU or computer systems in the car. They are built to handle that cold. Believe it or not, these are very robust automotive grade systems, and it takes a lot to kill them, but it's really the heat. The cold can make the touchscreen and the actual LCD panels sluggish. I have seen it and experienced it when we had negative 32 degrees Fahrenheit one night, where the center screen would not turn on. The electronics, everything was active. I mean, I could even adjust the temperatures and everything by the physical controls. And it actually did register touches on the screen, like, you know, where the climate control on off spot is. You touch that, even though you can't see anything on the screen. I touched that and it did respond, but it was just so cold, the actual screen did not turn on. After about 3 minutes with the heat on in the car, then it came on. It brought up the temperature enough. While the cold isn't really going to cause a failure, it can cause delayed displays. Now, cold plus high moisture, that's when you get condensing moisture on things. And Teslas are pretty bad when it comes to keeping the interior moisture free. Even if you select outside air coming in, it's like these computers, they have them programmed where they just don't want you to get outside air in these damn cars unless you got the defrosters on. But it's not so much pronounced on the inside interior as it, except for the windows. So it's really not too much of an issue. And that's pretty much it. I haven't had an outright failure of a screen, and I doubt unless there's an actual manufacturing defect in the screen. Of course, like everything, it keeps getting improved upon and improved and improved. So it is becoming less of an issue. Now, some of the early ones did have defects in them. But if you think back, the Model S came out in end of 2012, so 2013, 14, 15, 16, 17. The very first Model S's are 5 years old already. Can you believe it? 5 years. So if it is going to be an age-related thing, we'll be seeing that more so now. But pretty much everybody I know that has an older Model S, Signature, Founders Edition, early production, they're really not having any MCU issues. Another thing that can fail on the MCU due to heat, and it's rare, but it does happen, is it's called bubbling. And it looks like there's little water droplets or air bubbles between the layers of the center screen. And that can stem from both heat and or impact. So if it gets too many hard impacts, and it should, in terms of impacts, it'll take a lot. But in terms of heat, more likely to happen. You'll get these little bubbles all over the screen. While it looks bad, it will still work. But if your car is under warranty, they will replace your screen for that. And that covers it. Thanks, Keith, for the question. And on to the next one. Any questions, please post them in the description box below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'm going to try and do more of these question and answer sessions.